Good morning students. So in this class we are going to discuss about Moller's law and uses of polaroids. So consider an unpolarized light. So it is placed behind the polarizer. So the unpolarized light is become plane polarized after passing through the polarizer P1. Then it is analyzed using an analyzer. So the angle between, so this is the transmission axis of polarizer. So this is the transmission axis of analyzer. So theta is the angle between the transmission axis of polarizer and analyzer. So just see, so this is electric field vector. So you will get a plane polarized light after passing through the polarizer. So again, if you see through the analyzer, you will get some light. So if it is along the polarizer, so the analyzer is along with the direction of polarizer, you will get the maximum light. If there is a rotation, if you rotate the analyzer from 0 to maximum, that is 0 to 90 degree, you will get the intensity of light varies. So now the analyzer is rotated to a certain angle. So this is the transmission axis. So you will get some light, but so this angle, so the transmission axis of analyzer and transmission axis of polarizer makes an angle theta. So it makes, so this is the electric field vector E. So it makes an angle theta. So this one. So from this, so the intensity of light, so here I is the intensity of unpolarized light after passing through the polarizer. So here the intensity of light is reduced to half, that is I by 2, that is I0, that is the maximum light from the polarizer. So here after transmitting through the analyzer, so what is the intensity of light? So that is directly proportional to the cosine of the angle. So here that electric field vector E have a amplitude E. So that amplitude, so that intensity of light after transmitting the analyzer, so the analyzer is, it is slanting, that oriented certain angle theta. So the transmitted light is directly proportional to that amplitude of that electric field vector. So here the amplitude, so this is a electric field vector amplitude. So it have two components. So it's a rectangular two components, A cos theta and A sin theta. So here that A cos theta, so just see, this is A cos theta. So just like that. So A cos theta only transmits through the analyzer. So this, just see, this is X, this is Y. So this is a long part. So this, this one is X, so A cos theta. So this one, this one is A sin theta. So this is the resultant amplitude vector A. So that A cos theta is transmitted inside the analyzer, we will get the resultant. So the intensity of the transmitted light from the analyzer I is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude of that electric field vector. So just square it. So it's A square cos square theta. So just is directly proportional, use the proportionality constant K. So K A square is equal to I0. So I is equal to I0 cos square theta. So from this we have a small discussion. So K is 1. So theta is a transmission angle between, so it's a transmission angle between the polarizer and transmission angle between the analyzer. It makes an angle theta. So if the angle theta is 0, so the polarizer analyzer both in the along the same axis. So along the same axis means theta equal to 0. So here cos 0, so cos 0 equal to 1. So the intensity is same. So I is equal to I0. If the analyzer is rotated to certain angle, that is 90 degree, so that transmission angle, then here the transmission angle of analyzer is perpendicular to each other, means angle theta equal to 90 degree. So cos 90 is 0, so you won't get the transmitted light. So intensity is 0. So they have given one problem. So here it is rotated to 30 degree. So you will get, so the angle theta equal to 30 degree. So what is the intensity of light transmitted out from the analyzer? So we know I is equal to I0 cos square theta. So just substitute. So that I0 equal to I by 2, because So half of the intensity of light is absorbed by the polarizer. So again balance cos square theta. So cos square 30 degree. So cos 30 equal to root 3 by 2. So I by 2 root 3 by 2 whole square. So you will get I by 2 3 by 4. So you will get 3I by 8 is the intensity of light emitted from the analyzer if the analyzer is rotated at angle 30 degree. So if you use one problem, you can understand more clear than uses of polaroids. So it is used in goggles and cameras to avoid glare of light. So they may ask in 2 marks or 3 marks. So what are the uses of polaroids? So in 3D motion pictures, that is 3 dimensional motion pictures, that is holography. Then to improve the contrast in old oil painting. Then it is used in optical stress analysis. Then polarized laser beam is acts as a needle to read and write the compact disc, that is CD. Then it is used in window glass, so in aeroplane and some other trains, to control the intensity of that incoming light. If you use polarizer and analyzer, so two glasses there, if you rotate it, so the intensity of light is reduced coming inside the train or aeroplane. So window of glass to control the intensity incoming of light from the solar radiation. Then polaroids. So polaroids, from the polaroids we get polarized lights, so to be used in liquid crystal display. So in this class we have discussed so Mahler's law, so that I is equal to I0 cos square theta, then uses of polaroids.